What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo, and in today's video, we are finally diving in to the brand new album from Billie Eilish. I recently moved, so I'm a little bit behind. This is like my second day being able to shoot, so I'm really looking forward to checking out Happier Than Ever. As you guys know, I am a pretty big fan of Billie Eilish. I actually praise these two records so much. I feel like there is just absolute perfection in these two records. This one being a real test of time. I feel like this album is going to continue to get replayability forever. It's just so good. It's so well produced. I think her and Phineas together create such perfect music. I'm really looking forward to this. I feel like When We All Fall Asleep definitely had a darker and more depressing sound to it, and I'm really looking forward to see what changes up here. Now, there are two tracks that I've listened to already on this album, so I won't be doing them on this album reaction, but I checked out Lost Cause and Your Power. I actually did full videos to both of those tracks, so if you're interested in checking out my thoughts on those songs, I'll link them in the description so you guys can check that out. Now, before we get into today's video, I just want to plug my Patreon. Everything I'm able to do on here is because of Patreon, so I'm so thankful to everyone that supports me over there. I try to do a lot of exclusive content. For Billie, I actually did this album as a full uncut album reaction. And I also did a watch party to her documentary. So if you're interested in checking that out, her Apple Music documentary, make sure to go check it out over there. And I would like to say that this album will be available over there as a full uncut listening party. That's where we jam the whole thing. I don't cut anything out. Obviously, with YouTube, I cut a lot of the music out. It still gets copyrighted, but I'd rather just not play the entire album. So if you want to check out Patreon, the link is in the description. Means the world to me. And with that long-winded intro out of the way, I am throwing the headphones on. We are going to appreciate the I can already tell this is going to be perfect. I just, from the couple of tracks I've heard already, this is just going to be so good. So we are starting with Getting Older. That I'm thankful, there's a lot I'm grateful for. I never get tired of her voice. When the stranger's always waiting, the stranger seemed to want me. Oh, you can already hear that production coming to life here, even just having her do double layers of her own vocals and it kind of like coming out on this side of my headphones. So sick. Which is ironic, because when I wasn't honest, I was still being ignored. Looking for attention, just to get neglection. I love this, like, inner perspective we're getting from Billie right now, just kind of like basically narrating how she's feeling in life right now. And it's really cool because obviously she started out pretty young in her career, so a lot of people that have been listening to her are kind of growing up with her, and I think that some of the lyrical content she's already kind of talked about here is something that a lot of people can really relate to. Now we're estranged. Okay, well, there is definitely a narration that I wasn't expecting to get, but I think it's important to acknowledge that things I once enjoyed now are keeping me employed. So my thought obviously goes to the music and loving to create the music. Obviously, there's got to be a lot of passion and a lot of love in that, otherwise you wouldn't do it. But at some point, it does become a job, and I think that anyone who's creative and ended up getting some success kind of understands what that feels like. It becomes a job. And yeah, it's just, it's always interesting to hear artists that you love start to actually talk about that because it makes it real. Things I'm longing for. Someday I'll be bored of. It's so easy. Ooh! Oh my god, that run! Oh, that little run! Okay, this is a great way to intro this album. I will say that based on this song, I don't know if the tone of the album is going to be what I originally predicted, which was that we were actually going to get like a happy track or a happy album from her. I do see that there is definitely a possibility there, though, because obviously she does seem at the end being more optimistic. Sometimes being honest is a way to let yourself feel those feelings and then move on from them. And she even said, I've been through some trauma. I did some stuff I didn't want to, but I never really told you guys about that. And so now I'm going to. And I think that with a track like this, obviously it's not, it's is a much slower pace. We're not coming right out of the gate with something banging, but what we're getting is a very introspective moment from Billy. And that is something that I can definitely appreciate. I'm always going to be here for music where you have to start just like admitting some of your faults and admitting some of the problems you're going through in order to have that change and to make that happen. So I'm here for it. A couple of the runs she does in this sounds, they just sound so beautiful. And it really makes me excited to see kind of what she's going to do with her vocals as we move through this album. Okay, this next track we're listening to is called I Didn't Change My Number. What the fuck?
Didn't change my number.
Oh, this is fucking dope.
Only changed who I replied to.
Why do I feel like I vibed to that? I didn't change my number, I just changed who I replied to. Fuck.
Laura said I should be nicer.
Ooh.
But not to you. I love her, you were mad at me. Don't take it out on me.
God damn.
I'm out of sympathy for you. Maybe you should leave. But this can be deceiving.
I kind of feel like we're talking about the same person we were talking about in Lost Cause as well on this track.
I gotta work, I go to work, you don't. Before I get too mean and take it out.
What? Her fucking vocal right there?
Take it out on you.
Woo! God. Phineas is doing something totally different on this. I love this. No! So what I'm loving right here is Billy absolutely feeling herself. She is, again, having a little bit of reflection over a relationship that ended. And I just love the fact that she puts it all out there in a way that seems like it's obviously for the better. And she's sort of just like calling out all of these issues that led her to where she is at now in this relationship. I didn't change my number, just who I reply to. I vibe with that. I didn't change my number, just who I believe in. Vibe with that. And I love the fact that she even name drops a little bit in this. She's like, you know what? I just stopped talking to you. And I wish I would have when this person told me that you were bad news. I should have just listened. But instead, I continued to dive down this path. This is a type of sound for Billie Eilish that I want to hear more of. I think that her and Phineas on this track, it obviously had that darker feel like we had in When We All Fall Asleep. But there was something just a little bit different about it. And I think a lot of it comes down to Billie Eilish's confidence, and as she continues to get older and continues to get better in these like fucking tracks that she makes and all the success that she's had, you actually see these different moments really coming to life from her. And I am, yes, oh yeah, this next one just continues that attitude. It's called Billy Bossa Nova.
It comes without a warning.
Oh,
cause waiting for it gets so boring.
God, the bass is so good.
A lot can change in 20 seconds. Can happen in the dark. Love when it makes sense. I'm not sentimental, but there's something.
Dude.
About the way you look tonight.
Okay, this is one of the reasons that I'm so excited to be like getting into her career so early, is that as we continue, you know, she's obviously like so much success at such a young age. I can't wait to see where she goes, because these are sounds that I've never really heard from her, and her bringing this to life just shows that there are so many sides of Billie Eilish.
Makes me wanna take a picture, make a move, an obsession. You really make a strong impression.
God, the bass lines in this. So I can't tell if Billie's singing about a relationship that she's got, just like she's trying to keep on the down low, or if it's an affair. I know she was talking about using different names at check-in and stuff, but that's something that celebrities have to do anyway. So I don't quite know. Based off the vibe, it kind of feels like a little bit of an affair, but maybe not. I'm not sentimental, but there's something about the way you look tonight. It could just be about a hookup, just a romantic hookup. Makes me wanna make them jealous. You better lock your door. Look at me a little more. It's that confidence is radiating in this. Honestly, these instrumentals so far have been so fucking solid. And everything sounds just a little bit different. So still, just off the first listen, I can't tell if this song is actually about just like an affair or maybe just a relationship that's kind of like low key, so nobody knows about it. But I think as this album even progresses, we're seeing a lot of Billie in a different light. I think that while she's always had a level of confidence when it comes to like attitude, especially like when we watch her live stuff, she's always just got this fucking awesome attitude when she performs, and you can tell that she's just fucking feeling it. But in the music, though she's always had that, it's always been a little bit different, and I feel like now on this one, it's a little bit more like she's feeling herself, and that's obviously what we want. We want, you know, we want that self-love. We want you to know that you are just fucking badass and bring those vibes out, and that's what I'm getting in Billie Bossa Nova. So please let me know in the comment section if you guys actually know what this is about. I try not to pull up the song meanings and stuff because I think it takes away some of the fun of just listening to a song. So you guys will have to let me know. This next one, I thought that I had heard it before, but I checked my channel and I've never done a reaction to it. So we're gonna do it. It's My Future. I've definitely heard this track before. Do you understand with my future? Can't wait to meet her. God damn. This is the type of shit I'm saying, though. We go from I Didn't Change My Number and Billie Bossa Nova to this, like, perfect fucking ballad where Billie just showcases that vocal strength and just how many different ways she can, like, approach these songs. Ooh! I love that. She's basically saying, like, there is this idea that if you're single or if you're alone, that you're unhappy. And what she's saying is, like, I'm not that way. I'm in love with the fact, I'm in love with who I'm going to be and the things that I'm going to achieve in life. It doesn't have to always be a significant other to bring me happiness. So vibey. And you aren't gonna know her. Man, I could just fucking listen to her sing anything. Like, she just got such a fucking personality in her vocal, and it just comes to life. I love this. There's a positive moment here where it's, look, I don't always have to search for a relationship, and I don't want to fall back into a relationship because right now I'm focused on somebody, and that somebody just happens to be me, and I'm going to continue to follow that path and see where that leads me, where my future brings me, and I'm going to stay in love with that person because anything that's going on right now may not be healthy and may not be nourishing that future version of myself who I have come to be very close with, and that's who I'm looking forward to meet. And I even said, like, because you don't, or something about my future, because you don't know her. Yeah, exactly. You don't know who I'm going to be in the next 5 years. And I don't know if you being in my life is going to necessarily continue that narrative that I'm looking for. And I think that if you can take over your life and you can take over your happiness, if you can find control over your own happiness, you are just going to be literally unstoppable. All right, the next track we're checking out is called Oxy. This feels like a Black Eyed Peas beat right here.
Can't take it back once it's been set in motion. You know I love to rub it in like glue. People say you can see it clear as day.
This is so sick. I can see it clear as day. You don't really need to pray. Billy, this is my moment.
Once it's been set in motion, I've been loosening up your collar.
Fuck yeah!
Breathing. Don't you even think of getting involved. You should really run away.
Hey! This instrumental is so fucking heavy. There it is. Hey! Holy shit. Billy is a whole fucking mood in this song. This is her in her domination status. She is saying, like, I'm going to find that happiness by causing you pain, by bringing you down. I want to do bad things to you. I want to make you scream. I want to make you yell. And what I love so much is that they were able to create a instrumental for this track that just literally goes so well with the lyrics of this song. It is very deep. It is very heavy. And I feel like we're getting some really experimental moments from Phineas when it comes to the production on these sides. I know When We All Fall Asleep definitely had its moments like this, but I think this album is pushing both of them even further in their music careers. And that's something that I really like to fucking hear. This is so dope. Yes, she fucking killed it with this. Okay, this next one is called Goldwing. Can I just say that the last song was like so heavy and dark, and then this song feels like it's being recorded by like a church choir. Oh shit. What is about to happen? I don't know, but I can feel it. Oh! Hey! Hey! This is so fucking dope. Oh my God, wait a minute. These are the little personality quirks in the songs that I think I tend to love so much. Like even at the end, all right, that's good. We're done. We're gonna wrap it up there. I'm not gonna lie, as far as lyrics go in that song, I have no fucking idea what was going on. And the reason being is that when you have a song that is such well produced like that, not only just with a perfect instrumental, but even with Billy's vocals in this and some of the effects that were used on Billy's vocals to add it into the instrumental, something that Kanye does a lot of. It's a style that he just got so popular on, and he does a really great job with it. Billy in this just sounds like literally in that first half, like she is coming straight out of a choir, and it just sounds so beautiful. And again, you're getting those moments from her vocals. But man, I knew at that halfway point, I could tell something was about to happen with this instrumental. And I'm so happy that Phineas and Billy make music together. They really are setting the fucking paving stones for the rest of the way of what music is sort of going to look like for the next few years. And I think there's something really special about that, especially in a track like this, where even if I can't take away from the lyrics on it, there's such a fucking vibe and a moment in this. And I think this is definitely, like I said, these next few years are Billy's moment, like 100%. The next track is Lost Cause, but like I said, we already did a full video to that. So I did like a full like 11 minute video talking about that song. So I'm going to leave that in the description. And we're going to go on to the next one, which is Haley's Comet. Hallie's Comet. Is it Haley or Hallie? Holly's. Maybe she'll say it.
In my dreams, I seem to be more honest. And I must admit you've been in quite a few. Haley's Comet takes for me to break a promise. Silly me to fall in love with you.
So I am definitely getting that narrative is still sticking around from I Didn't Change My Number, from Goldwing, and even from My Future, if I'm being honest. I think we're talking about the same person, obviously, in Lost Cause. We're talking about the same person throughout this.
I haven't slept since Sunday. Ooh, I was good at feeling.
God, her vocal delivery in this.
What a drag to love you like I do.
Wait, see, I don't know if this is a positive or not, because I've been loved before, but in this moment, like, basically, I was made for you. That's how I'm feeling. So I don't know if it's necessarily about the same person we've been talking about. Yeah, that line straight up throws off my whole narrative there. Uh-oh. I love all the classical piano work in this. Just so fucking cool. So I really can't tell in this song from Billy if we're in a positive moment where she was obviously trying not to fall in love, but things just kind of happened and things aligned and she feels like she found the person that she's meant for. I really thought this was about sort of the breakup that we've kind of been experiencing through some of these other songs, especially whenever Lost Cause plays right before this track. But I can't help but feel like there's something more positive in this song. I do like, and I think this is one of those just personality things that you get from Billy and Phineas, but I like how it goes into this cosmic sounding moment where it sounds like she's floating through space and she says, I'm sitting in my brother's room. I haven't slept in a week. I think I might have fallen in love, or something along those lines. And one, you can picture that, especially, you know, if you've watched any of the documentaries or behind the scenes stuff, then you know, they recorded all of those songs in her brother's room. But also you get this sort of moment where you're just kind of like very introspective again. And I think that's something that this album is doing a really great job of, is I think that Billy is being very honest with us, even though, like, I'm definitely confused a little bit on the relationship as we're going through this. But you're getting more of those really personal moments from Billy. And that's something that, I don't know, to me, that's the kind of stuff that makes you go back to an album time and time again, is to be able to hear a person kind of talk about their experiences going through life, especially a person that ended up, you know, being so fucking successful already. And there's so much more to come. This next track is called Not My Responsibility. God, some of this is so deep. I just want to listen to this on vinyl right now. Fucking tell them, Billy! Fucking tell them!
Some people hate what I wear.
Well, fuck them.
Some people praise it. Some people use it to shame others. Weaker, softer, taller. Would you like me to be quiet? Do my shoulders provoke you? Does my chest? Am I my stomach? Body I was born with. Is it not what you wanted? If I wear what is comfortable, I am not a woman. If I shed the label, if I wear more, if I wear less, who decides what that makes me? What that means? Is my value based only on your perception? Or is your opinion of me not my responsibility?
I know this sounds, it sounds like it's possibly going to be a transition. I have to stop it though, because we have to talk about this. So one thing that I've always known about Billy, even when I didn't know much about her music, was the amount of opinions people have about her. Obviously, she's got plenty of positive opinions. She's got a very loyal fan base. I feel like I'm in that boat. I'm a huge fan of Billy. I like her personality. After watching her documentary on Patreon, I actually love her even more. I feel like you get to see a very real side of her that you don't always get with your favorite artists. Now, having said that, there is definitely another side, and I do feel like she gets a lot of hate. She gets a lot of criticism. There are a lot of negative opinions about her, and it stems from so many different things. One being her, obviously her style, which is super fucking dope. Reminds me a lot of like nu metal, and a lot of like 90s nu metal and stuff with like JNCOs and things like that. But she gets a lot of negativity for that. People that don't think she's fashionable, even though like she's brought back an entire trend. Like I see stores selling the clothes that she wears now. And I think that's a really fucking amazing moment. That's like a giant fuck you to everyone who's a hater. But I also see, like, especially with When We All Fall Asleep, there was a lot of people coming out saying that she's making evil music for their children and kind of giving her this like really, I guess, like fucked up moment where it's like she's apparently supposed to be in charge of every person that listens to her music and decides what they should and shouldn't listen to, which was rough. I've seen a lot of comments about her body, her physical appearance. That is something that I've never quite understood when it comes to, I mean, really anything, but if we want to just dissect it for what this is for the music industry. You know, she is an icon, and she is also a celebrity. She's at A-list status, and it amazes me how some of the narratives that you hear really do discuss her physical appearance and over-sexualizing her, especially when she wasn't even of age. Like, there's a lot of really fucked up stuff that goes on, and it's, you know, it's something that she struggles with on the back end, obviously. Like, she doesn't always talk about it in the light. So for her to make this little interlude right here, very deep hitting, instrumental in the back for her to just narrate this, I think it's a really important moment because it's really like a, hey, I see you, you are heard, fuck you. You know what I mean? And I love that so much for her because it's a chance to let her get that off of her own shoulders without having to bear the responsibility that people have assumed that she's supposed to have just based on the kind of music she makes and how she dresses. I just think this is a fucking call to action right here in the best way. Okay, and I think it transitions into the song Overheated.
I don't really know how it happened. Instead of stopping, they still were flashing.
I started walking, gave no reaction. Can't be deleted. Can't unbelieve it. I'm heated.
Honestly, Phineas has taken a much different approach to the production on this album. I know I've mentioned that a couple times, but it's really important. And it really sticks out in tracks like this, where you're hearing a lot of like vocal samples in the back and stuff. Something they've done before, but maybe not to this extent. It's really badass.
You wanna kill me, you wanna hurt me, stop being flirty. It's kinda working.
She's so badass.
Don't you really think this is the right thing to do? Didn't get a surgery to help her, cause I'm not about to read this on myself.
Fuck. Okay, this song is so fucking dope. There's a decent amount of fade outs in this album as well, I'm noticing. Okay, if it was up to me, we would get more songs on more Billie albums where she is just talking her shit and having her moment. And I think that's exactly what we're getting here. Again, we are getting a very confident version of Billie in this, being able to say how she feels, express how she feels, and not worry about the consequences. And though that was kind of the case in When We All Fall Asleep, it was a little bit different because this has a much more personal tone to it. She's talking about some stories that she actually went through and overheated. And I feel like when you mix that attitude and that feeling that you have towards this subject with a beat like Phineas has made in this, I'm just assuming Phineas made all these beats. Of course. I believe Phineas one time said he doesn't trust anyone else to produce Billie. And that is a smart way to do it because everything that they put out together is just absolute gold. But when you have these two working together and understanding the tone of the song and the attitude of the song, it really comes to life in a track like this. And I think even when Billie kind of had some bars there towards the end, it all works so well. And I would actually love to hear more songs along this style from her, because I think especially coming off of Not My Responsibility, you're already getting this like sort of fire heating up in these tracks. And then Overheated just comes through and blows it. Oh, I just said Overheated and I said fire in these tracks. Okay, I did not mean for that to be a pun, but I'll take it. Anytime you can get a dad pun, you're going to be happy. But she blows it out of the water with Overheated. And I feel like, again, it's just that approach. It's that, I don't know, that kind of swag going on in there where she's not afraid to just call out the things around her. All right, the next track we're going into is a track called Everybody Dies.
Surprise, surprise. We tell each other lies. Sometimes. We try to make it feel like we might be right. We might not be alone.
God damn.
Everybody dies.
Okay, little things like what I just heard make me love her even more. So you can hear her take like a almost like a very like emotional sigh right before she starts the next moment. And it's little things that are left in the production like that that make everything she makes just feel so real.
That's what they say. And maybe in a couple hundred years, they'll find another way. It's just a lot to think about the world I'm used to. The one I can't get back, at least not for a while. I sure have a neck.
That bass in the back.
Life more like a child. It's not my fault, it's not so wrong to want. You are not unknown.
even in the fade out, they're still working on those instrumentals. So this is another one of those songs where lyrically I can't tell right from the get-go what we're really singing about here, but part of me kind of feels as I'm listening to this that we are almost having she's having a conversation with fans perhaps or listeners that everybody dies, it's no big surprise, but you don't have to be scared, even though you'll probably be scared when it's your time to come. No one really knows when that time is. And the reason I say that is because I kind of thought she was, again, I just think everything goes back to a relationship, but I kind of thought she was being, having the perspective of like, everybody dies. So like, there's only a limited time on earth. So you don't want to spend it with someone that you're not happy with. That's kind of what I was picking up at first. But then she says, you are not alone and you are not unknown. At least I think that's what she says. And it kind of almost feels like her reaching out to people that are struggling or in that time where they feel like they're alone or feel like they have no one else, but you realize that everyone dies. And so we're all kind of in the same boat, even though we may be different kinds of people. At the end of the day, we all have the same fate. And while that does sound obviously very sad and scary, it's more of a way to sort of humanize people. Because we put people up on pedestals sometimes where we feel like we're not going to achieve these things of greatness. And even though people will, and we should strive to try to do something that makes us happy and makes the world a better place, at the end of the day, we're all going to perish. Even Jeff Bezos flying a dick to the moon, he is still going to perish. And I think that it sort of evens the playing field a little bit, and it makes you feel like you're not so alone. Even though I'm terrified of death, I don't want to die. Life is fucking cool. But I also realize that it's impending and just hopefully it doesn't happen anytime soon. Like I said, I did an entire video on your power, so I'll link that down in the description. I also, I listen to this Therefore I Am all the time. So I'm not going to do that one in here either because I know that song like the back of my hand at this point. I did not know that it was on this album, so I have a feeling this album's going to do some pretty incredible numbers. So the next track that we're listening to is NDA, which I know she did a music video for, but I haven't actually heard the song yet. Let's do it. 17. I haven't had a party since I got the keys. Had a pretty boy over, but he couldn't stay. On his way, I made him sign an NDA. That's what I'm talking about, though. This is Billy feeling herself. On his way, I had to make him sign an NDA. Yeah, I made him sign an NDA. Ooh! I don't want to manage. I can crave your texturing on her voice is so good. Woo! Oh my god, it sounds like Nine Inch Nails. Okay. So first off, I can already tell that there is a fucking sweet little vibe into Therefore I Am from that track. I think NDA is my favorite track I've heard on this so far. It's my favorite song on the album so far. Holy shit. Like, it's so hard hitting. And there's a couple different things that are going on with the production plus with Billy's vocals that really make it sonically just like one of the coolest things I've heard on this. And I've heard a lot of really fun stuff, but there's something about this track in particular. I think it has to do with the fact that I'm seeing more of that creativity from Phineas, but at the same time, I'm seeing sort of what future Billy is going to sound like in this. Even when you hear a little bit of the texturing or enhancement, whatever you want to call it, effect. I like vocal effects. the vocal effects on her vocal when she goes into that chorus right before the beat drops, it just sounds so fucking powerful. Also, we're getting to that moment again. Billie's feeling herself. Had a cute boy over, but he couldn't stay. On his way, I had to make him sign an NDA. You know what? I'm here for Billie feeling herself and singing about it. I think that she's going to get so much praise for this. And also, like I said, with this track, track 13, NDA, I'm just feeling like I'm hearing little moments that we're going to start to hear more and more throughout her future albums, and I'm ready for it. Therefore I Am is an absolute banger. I'm just going to say that. I know we're not reacting to it, but goddamn, it is an absolute banger. That song gets played in my car probably once a day. I had no idea they were putting it on this album, and yeah, I'm here for it. Okay, I was told I was going to love this track, so this is Happier Than Ever.
When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever.
Okay, that pretty much sums up kind of my feelings on some of the relationship moments that have been going on in here. I wasn't sure if Happier Than Ever was going to be sarcasm. And I was actually going to talk about that because it seems like some of this has been very like more like optimistic, I could say. There's definitely like an overwhelming tone of a little bit of sadness kind of going on. So I thought Happier Than Ever was going to be sarcasm. But after that line, kind of feels like, you know, her being alone or by herself or away from this person, she's starting to feel better.
If I knew when I asked you to be cool about what I was telling you, you would do the opposite of what you said you'd do, and I'd end up more afraid.
God damn.
Isn't fair. You clearly weren't aware that you made me miserable. So if you really want again, drunk in the Benz, driving home under the influence. You scared me to death, but I'm wasting my breath, 'cause you only listen to your fucking friends. I don't relate to you.
Woo!
I don't relate to you, no, 'cause I'd never treat me this shitty. You made me hate this.
Oh. Fuck yeah! I want to see her do this live. I spoke just a little bit too soon when I said NDA was my favorite. NDA is my second favorite. Happier Than Ever is the coolest fucking song on this album. One of the biggest reasons being that I've never heard Billie do this style, really. So for her to bring it to life in this like she just did, I am fucking so here for it. I love that the first 2.5 minutes of this track are like little acoustic ukulele moments. She's kind of just expressing these different things and how she's been a lot happier because she's no longer in this relationship. The relationship that we've been talking about throughout this entire album. I feel better now that I've heard this song and that is actually what was happening. I have a feeling it's about that dude from the documentary, but I don't know. So you guys can let me know. But he definitely seems like he fits the bill on most of these songs. So it's probably him. But then we get to that moment where I could just tell the guitar changed up a little bit. And I was like, all right, what's about to happen? I was expecting more of a Phineas style beat, kind of like he's had in this. I had no idea we were going to get like a straight up rock moment in this. And the guitar sounded so fucking awesome. And I could hear Billie multi-layered, or she had people in the gang vocal. I don't quite know. But it just created such a big moment there where she could just be herself and have that feeling. And I got to say that now, I need to see her perform this live. I also need her to do more of this style. She named the album Happier Than Ever. The title track from this album is this huge rock moment. I definitely need more of that from her. This is my favorite song on the album, hands down. All right, this last track is called Male Fantasy.
In the dialogue, she would never be that satisfied. It's a male fantasy. I'm going back to therapy. Guess it's hard to know when nobody else comes around. If I'm getting over the purple years ago, thought we'd get along, but it wasn't so. But I loved you then.
God damn. Her in that higher range is just like it's such a perfect sound, because you don't often hear it in every song that you really hear. She usually sings them like either more of like a talking style or a little bit lower. So those higher ranges are always just so fucking perfect.
No matter what I do, I know I should, but I could never hate you.
Oh my God. Fuck, what an intense way to end this song, or to end this album, especially after coming off of Happier Than Ever. Such a high energy moment on this, and then to go into Male Fantasy, which to me, it's Billy having another one of those introspective moments where she has just laid out sort of a lot of these moments of this relationship that she was in through that into that failed, and kind of like all of the things that kind of happened because of that, or how she was feeling after that, and how she's getting to a point where she's actually happy now. But then we get to Male Fantasy, and she is basically having that thing of like, man, I just told you guys all this, but the truth is, like, I don't know if I'm actually over this person or if I'm just pretending to be, but like, no matter how they made me feel, no matter how fucking like horrible everything was, I can't bring myself to hate this person. And I mean, that's a really big moment. Like, that's a big moment for anybody to be able to make that song, because typically we get into a situation where it's just so easy to, you know, hate someone that did us wrong or that made us feel terrible. But the truth is, like, we can say we hate someone all we want, but usually, like, it's not actually real. And oftentimes, if we're not actually over somebody, we'll tell everybody we are, but we're struggling on the inside. And the thing about Billy is that Billy put it out there in the open to let everyone know how she's actually feeling. So we basically got to live the end result of that relationship that she went through. And this is just like a big fucking moment to end this album. So I gotta say right away, this is my favorite Billy album. Just on first listen alone, not even understanding the full concept of all the lyricism here, there is a huge jump between When We All Fall Asleep and Happier Than Ever. I feel like this album took an entire leap, and it's crazy because her and Phineas won so many awards for When We All Fall Asleep, and it's obviously like put up on a pedestal as this amazing album. And I still feel that way. I really do feel like this album is going to be played forever. People are going to talk about this album forever. There's some really amazing things in here, especially the fact that it was recorded in a bedroom. I feel like that alone is already badass, but the album is incredible. I already fell in love with it. Then after that, I watched the documentary and I really got more perspective about Billy and about Phineas. And I think that I really started to understand more of their creative process while at the same time understanding the chemistry that the two have between each other to really create music that is impactful and long lasting. Also, while kind of setting trends and making things more popular. So, leads me to Happier Than Ever. I think we're getting those moments. We're also getting a chance to see Billy in an entirely new light, where she is very introspective. She's being very honest with some of the things she's struggling with and dealing with. And even though we saw that in When We All Fall Asleep, I think I could see in the documentary where there was a lot more that she wanted to be saying and wasn't sure what she should be saying. And that's something that people struggle with. You don't know what your image is going to look like. And she took Happier Than Ever and decided, you know what? I'm going to fucking tell the story. I'm going to tell my story how I want to tell it. And people will, you know, think of it the way they do. I think that this album hits. I literally need to go buy the vinyl today because I need to listen to this on my turntable. I feel like there's so much in this. And Billy honestly sounds so good on vinyl anyway. So I definitely want to hear this. My favorite tracks, Happier Than Ever, NDA, and probably I Didn't Change My Number, also Getting Older, and oh my god, Overheated. So those are my favorites on first listen. Obviously those will change a ton, but there's just something about those. I do want to talk about Getting Older and Not My Responsibility though, because those were Billy essentially narrating what it's like to go through that fame, what it's like to get all this success, and kind of what that does to you and how that kind of affects you. And I think Getting Older really put that in perspective. But Not My Responsibility was that direct middle finger to everyone that has always kind of created these news articles and opinions about the way she looks and how she dresses and what her body looks like and the over-sexualization that people had of her when she was 16 and 17. And it's really disgusting. And so for her to be able to take those moments and kind of put it into this and summarize it, I think is really incredible. So a huge fan of this album right away. I cannot wait to start editing this just so I can turn this album back on. I literally got to go buy the vinyl today. I got to leave my house and go buy this because I really want to hear this again on a turntable. I just think it would be so incredible. I really hope you guys like today's video. This is my new studio. Album reactions are coming back. And I'm really glad that we started off with Billy's most recent album. If you guys want to support the channel and get access to a ton of exclusive content, as well as being able to check out the Billie Eilish documentary and the full reaction to this, it'll be up already over there. Check out Patreon. The link is in the description. It means so much to me. Pretty much none of my videos are monetized on YouTube. I do this because I love it. So I'm really happy and thankful to have people that support me over on Patreon and allow me to do this. It's fucking amazing. I'm so appreciative. Thank you so much. Let me know in the comment section what your top five, because I picked five, your top five favorite songs on this album were. Let me know on Instagram and Twitter as well. I love you guys. I will see you in the next one. Peace.